homework and I'm in Ms. Wybie's fifth grade class. When I look around this room, I see my friends, my classmates, my teachers, my mentors, my family. But most importantly, I see happiness, I see joy, I see forgiveness, and I see memories. Amazing memories that I'll never forget. So I invite you to please continue listening to my speech about a memory from third grade at Bodkin Elementary that I will cherish and hold near and dear to my heart for the rest of my life. I think third grade was a changing point for me. I went from seeing school as just a place to learn and sit in a dark, quiet room for 6 hours to a place where I can make friends and make deep connections with teachers. Ms. Wybie is a great example of that connection. I remember in second grade when we got off for a 2-week period from school for a strange new virus. 2 weeks turned to 3 weeks, and 3 weeks turned to 4, and almost a year and a half later, there I was, sitting in my bedroom, longing for just one normal day of school. Finally, the email that felt like my first breath of fresh air came, informing us that we were going back to school 2 days a week. I think that first day back was the scariest thing I've been through. Walking into the building, it was hard to recognize the place I had known for the last 3 years, as it was coated and scattered with 6 feet apart signs, stickers on the floor, and desks that were pulled apart. This circumstance made me feel miles away from the people I didn't even realize I felt so strongly about. It didn't help that I could only see the eyes of the kids and teachers that I knew. The person who got me through those times was Ms. Elsis. Even though COVID was happening, she would still do online things with kids and support you in any way she could. Everything I've been through and done, she has been right by my side, and that scary different place had become a lot more scary after I talked to Ms. Elsis. My third grade year was the hardest year of my life. If I could do it again, I would. Because the first day of fourth grade, I felt like a cool breeze on a hot day. You don't realize what you take for granted until you don't have it anymore. I didn't realize how important being in school was until I almost lost it. I had the most amazing, wonderful, and exciting, adventurous time here at Bodkin, and I could not imagine a school better than this one. In the beginning of my speech, I listed all the things I see when I look around this room, but one thing I forgot to mention was love. That is the biggest emotion I feel about this place. As I'm writing this conclusion, tears are streaming down my face because I'm going to miss all the teachers, staff, volunteers, and students. Thank you, and for the very last time, I would like to say goodbye to Bodkin Elementary, the best we will ever see.